Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about disjoint set data structure. But before we start, a small information I'd like to give. We are producing all our videos in two different languages, Hindi as well as in English, so that you can watch the video in your preferred language. You can identify the language from the thumbnail of the video. If you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get all the notifications from this channel. So, let us start disjoint set data structure. Basically, disjoint data structure is a data structure that contains the partition set. If you remember the set theory, when we say that two sets are partitioned or two sets are disjoint, when there is no common element between these two sets. So, such kind of sets are also known as partition set. And these partition sets are separated by non-overlapping sets. As I already told you that their intersection must be phi. It is also called as union data structure or merge find data structure. We identify each set by a member which is known as representative. It means if a set is there, to identify the set, we will be having a member element. Through that member element, I'll say this element belongs to this particular set. We'll see during an example. Now, before we start, let us find what are the applications of disjoint set data structure. We use disjoint set data structure to find the connected component of an undirected graph, and we check whether a cycle exists in a graph or not. In our next video, we are going to have the application of disjoint data set. Please watch this. The first thing that we'll learn in any data structure is representation. So let us start about disjoint set data structures representation. So basically we represent disjoint set by two methods, one by linked list and other one is by using array. Let us use a linked list to find a disjoint set. Let us say we are having two sets S1 and S2. S1 contain the element 1, 2 and 3 and S2 contain 4 and 5. And let us assume that this is the graphical representation of this particular set. You can see that this graph, it seems to be like a tree, but there is a small difference here. In a tree or a binary tree, from root node, the arrows are pointed towards the child. But here, from the child node, arrows are pointed towards the root node. Why? Because even though we are using a linked list, the structure of the linked list remains the same. How many nodes or how many links you want to have, that remains the same. But in a set, you cannot say how many elements will be there in a particular set from the very beginning. So that's why if we are having a set where all the elements will point to its root or its representative, it becomes easy for us to represent. So here the element which is the root element is also known as the representative. When we are using linked list to represent a disjoint set, we'll be having a pointers like that. In first one, we'll be having the set name, and second one to which will keep the address of the representative. For this set, the representative is 2. So 2's address will be kept here. And for the second set, the representative is 4. So 4's address will be kept here. So this is how we are going to represent disjoint set data structure by using a linked list. Now, let us use array to represent a disjoint set data structure. The same sets we are taking, S1 and S2. And to represent a set, we'll take an array. So I will indicate the index and P will indicate the value. So the first thing what we'll do is, first thing we'll represent the root or the representative. A representative or the root will not having any root anymore. So we are going to write for the first set, the value will be -1. And for the second set, for 4, the value will be -1. Now for the first set, 1 is, 1's root is 2 and and 3's root is 2. So for 1 we'll write 2 and for 3 we'll write 2. Similarly for the second sets, 5 root is 4. So we'll write 5 root is 4. So this is how we represent a disjoint data structure using an array. Without any operations, there is no data structure exists. So here we are having two different operations, that is union and find. And to implement these data structure, we are having three operations defined. Make set of x, what it will do, it will create a new set, union of xy. X and y are the representative of two sets, and we are doing union operation. Find set of x, it will return the representative of that particular set. Let us see this with the help of an example. Make set of x. Let us say these are the elements we are having, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And we are saying make set of 1 and 2. We will be representing 1 and 2 with the help of a single set. So I can represent it in this way or in this way, because there is no restriction mentioned here. So 2 can be root or 1 can be root. So we are taking the first one right now. Because this set existed, that's why element 1 and 2 no more existing here. Now make set of 4 and 5. So 4 and 5 I can represent in this way. Either 5 can be root or the 4 can be root. And when we are having this set, this individual element will no more be existing. For our simplicity, we are taking the first one. Now we are going to see the make set of 1 and 3. So element 1 lies in this particular set and element 3 is lying as an individual element. So make set of 1 and 3 will make a set of this particular set with the element 3. So the for this particular set, the representative is 2. So this element 3 will be attached to 2 like this. Now this set 1, 2 is no more existing and the element 3 is no more existing. So we are having this set only. Now if we want to have element make set of 1 and 4, 1 is existing in this particular set whose representative is 2 and 4 is existing in this particular set whose representative is 5. Now as there is no restriction mentioned, I can make 5 as a representative of the combined set or I can make 2 as the representative of the combined set. Now here in this case we are making 2 as the representative of the combined set and it is represented in this way. It means the whole set 4, 5 becomes the child of the representative of the second set, that is 1, 3. So this is how we are going to use make set function to create different sets. Now the approach of disjoint set is not anything better than any linked list representation or of a tree. To improve the performance of the tree representation, we are using two concepts, that is union by rank or weight rule, and the second one is path compression. Let us see one by one. What is union by rank? So if I is the rank number of a particular root node in a set S1 and J is the rank number of a root node of a particular set S2, then union of I and J will be formed by these three formula. What is that? We'll make J as the parent of I if I is less than J. We'll make I as the parent of J if I is greater than J. And either I or J, I can make the parent of the other one if I is equal to Z. We'll see this with the help of an example. The same elements we are having, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when we are calling make set of 1 to the element 1, we are giving a rank, that is 0. And the loop indicating that it is a representative. Similarly for set 2, the rank is 0 and it itself is its representative. Like that, all the elements. Now let us find make set of 1 and 2. As the rank of 1 and 2 are same, then I can make 1 as the representative or 2 as the representative. So either of this I can use. The representative of the root will always be 1 more than its child. I am taking the first one here and I am calling the function make set of 4 and 5. Now we are having 4 and 5. Here also the rank is the same. Then I can use either 5 as the representative or 4 as the representative. So this is represented in this way. This loop represents the representative. Now make set of 1 and 3. Here 1 is present in this particular set with representative 2, and 2's rank is 1, and 3, the representative is 3 itself and its rank is 2. Here we compare the rank. Whose rank is higher, that will become the representative of the combined set, and the other one become the child. So you can see here, make set of 1, 3. Here 2 becomes the representative of the whole set, combined set, and whose rank becomes 1 and its child become 3. Now if I call make set of 1 and 4, now 1 is a part of this particular set whose representative is 2, whose rank is 1, and here 4 is present in this particular set and whose rank is also 1. Because both the set is having same rank, so I can make 5 as the representative of the combined tree or combined set, or I can make 2 as the representative of the combined set. Here we are making 2 as the representative. Rank will be increased by 1 for the representative when both of them having same rank and one becomes a child of the other one. The representative of the main set becomes 1 more than the other set. So here we are having that 1 and 3, as here 1 and 3 has rank 0, 4 has rank 0, 5 has rank 1 as usual, and 2 will be having rank 2. This is how we are going to use weight rule to find make set. Now let us see the path compression or collapsing rule. It says if J is a node on path from I to the root node and the parent of I is not equal to the root of I, then set parent of J to root of I. Let us see what is the meaning with the help of an example. We are having these sets already, we know. Now we are making make set of 1 and 4. So this is what we got till now. So here you can see 4's parent is 5 and 5 parent is 2, where for this whole set 2 is the representative, 2 is the root. So instead of making a path that is linking 4 to 2 through 5, we'll use the collapsing rule and directly make an edge from 4 to 2 and represent it in this way. So this is what the collapsing rule is. So make set operation makes a new set by creating new element with unique ID, a rank of 0. The parent pointer to itself indicates the element is representative of the member set. So if we want to write in the form of a function, it will be like this: function make set of x. If x is not already a parent, then add x to the disjoint set tree, then x becomes x's parent and 0 becomes the rank of x. For this, the complexity become order of 1, because every time one element only we are adding it to the particular set. Find x follows the chain of parent pointers from x upwards to the tree until the element is reached whose parent is itself. It means we are finding the representative of a particular set when we are using find of x. This element is the root of the tree and is the representative member of the set which x belongs to, and maybe x itself. To understand this, let us see this particular function find of x. If x is not equal to parent of x, then what we'll do? We'll call the find function with parent of x, and that will indicate as x as parent, and we'll continue this until we return x as parent. Let us try to understand how we did union. Union of x and y uses find to determine the root of the tree x and y belongs to. If the root are distinct, the trees are combined by attaching the root of one to the root of the other. Union by rank always attach the shorter tree to the root of the taller tree. and thus the resulting tree is no longer than the original unless they were of equal height. In that case, the taller height node will be increased by 1. Let us try to understand this with the help of an algorithm. Function union x and y will call find of x and will say x's root, and will call find of y and name it as y's root. If both the elements are in the same tree, then we cannot combine it. We'll just simply return it. And if they are not same, we'll follow the steps. If rank of x's root is less than the rank of y's root, then we'll say y's root becomes parent of root x. Otherwise, if rank of root x is greater than rank of root y, then root x becomes parent of root y. Otherwise, if both of them are same, I can write anything that here I am writing. X's root becomes parent of y's root, and the x's roots is increased by 1. For this, the time complexity will be big O of m. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Hope you understood it. Please see the next video where I am going to describe about the applications of this disjoint sets. Please like the video, share the video and comment on this particular video. I'll meet you in some other video. Till then, take care. Bye.